And then you grew up, you got married, had kids, did stuff for them, then grandchildren.
Nobody told me not to get married.
But how many, let's see, how many grandchildren?
I've got 8 grandchildren and 8 great-grandchildren.
Oh my goodness.
And she helped me pull up.
Did you ever have any art classes?
Yeah. I started art classes in Nashville when I was working there. And I've been going about 2 months when I met Yehu. I dropped out. I started running around with him.
Well, didn't slow you down. And how did you get into making Barbie doll clothes?
For you.
Aww.
When I bought you your first Barbie doll.
Yeah.
We got patterns and started making. I still got some of the patterns.
You still got some of the clothes you made for us. Oh, we're switching chairs.
I tell you, I wasn't expecting this. I thought I'd come over here and see a few things on the wall, and that'd be it. I appreciate all of you turning out to make me feel good.
Oh, that. Such talent.
Seriously.
What's your favorite thing to draw?
Women.
Women?
I used to draw paper dolls for my sisters.
Yeah.
Liz Taylor and Marilyn Monroe and Debbie Reynolds.
Awesome.
And I was a lot better then than I am now because I quit doing all that stuff and started having kids and started changing diapers. What do you want to know?
Where'd you meet Yehu?
Yehu?
Yehu.
Yehu. I met him at a, well,
racetrack?
Racetrack, drag race strip. What's the name of the place?
Union Hill, Tennessee.
Union Hill, Tennessee. My girlfriend and I had gone out because that's where all the boys were. And I met him there. And from there, it just got worse and worse.
I'm offended. How about you, Barry?
Well, just dragging, dragging.
Well, I've been blessed. God's really blessed me. A fine family. All of them are good Christian people. I'm just so proud of them. I know you shouldn't be proud, but I am. In your sins, I'm proud of my family. And they're all in church.
Were any of these from patterns, or did you kind of design them on your own?
These Barbie dolls?
No, the big dresses, the big girl dresses.
I have patterns for them. Still got some of them.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think that was the hardest one right there.
How long does it usually take to make a dress for a full size person?
All my life, it seems like. No, these, I made 8 of them, the peach colored one. It took me from spring or of 1 year when I found out she's getting married all the way to the next June when she got married because I made it for all the bridesmaids. And the rest of them didn't take that long, but I'd say I'll put a month in on them because he was working nights and sleeping days, so I had to be quiet during the day. So I got to work up till about midnight and I'd go to bed.
How many quilts have you made?
3 daughter, or you and 2 daughter-in-laws.
I think all the grandkids.
All the grandkids. And, all the grandkids. I didn't start with the great grandkids. I ran out of steam.
We'll pass them down.
Okay. I like your hair. It's about the color of our first son's was. It was the kind of, what they call
strawberry
blonde.
Pretty.
That's what I call it anyway. But it was awfully nice of all of you to turn out today.
Yeah.
And that's a lot to be said for Grace's talent.
I get it from you.
Something else that we really don't have here is her food. She's a great cook and baker, famous for her apple cake.
Yes, mm-hmm.
It's
over there.
Oh, is that her recipe?
That's right, yeah. Thank you. Thank you.
Yeah.
All the boxes checked.
Yeah, that's awesome. And banana pudding. And anytime grandma cooks, she usually has a table full.
That's so true, yeah.
Right?
You did some games. You wrote out some games that you used to play when you were younger.
Yeah.
Ben was here, and he was reading the games. And what was the one, Mary, that he was interested in? Was it the twirly one?
Twirly one, yeah.
Dad made that for us. He found a large plank about so long and about that wide and had a hole where the knot fell out in the middle. And he put that on the stump about that high with a bolt, I guess it was. And we get on that, and he starts going, and we go around and around. If it ever fell falling off, we'd probably been killed. But he'd come back and take us off when he got ready for some of the house. But he made a lot of our things like that we played.
And the stories that you wrote, they were tales for when you are going to sleep for your daughters and granddaughters. It makes sense, what it is.
Yeah, so she's asking, the tales that you wrote, were they like bedtime stories, or what? Why did you write them?
Two of those that I made up. The rest of them is true.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Which two?
The fish that talked, is that a real one? The fish that could talk?
Fish, yeah.
Little fish?
Little fish. And the snow, about the snow people.
Yeah, that was made up.
Snow angels, yeah.
The rest of them actually happened.
Wow.
They did it very actively. They used to roll up the rugs in one of our rooms, and anybody that played an instrument come in, and we square dance in that room, and put all the kids on the beds in the other rooms, and they'd go sleep, and go throw coats over to keep them warm. But that's the way I grew up, making our own regulation. We didn't have too much, barely put food on the table and clothes were back, but the rest of the time we had to do our own thing. So I guess that's where we got a lot of our creativity. And in the wintertime, we had nothing to do but sit around the fireplace. So that's when we colored and drew and cut out paper dolls. And we used to take the catalogs and cut out the women in the catalogs and make cars out of matchboxes with little wheels on them and set them in that. I mean, you get creative when you don't have anything to do with. So that's the way I was raised, poor. I used to chop cotton, pull corn. I'd grow a team of horses to a wagon and rode them. And my biggest thing, which I loved best, when we started home on summer day, we'd go through my grandpa's pasture and then right, then walk through the pond with us. So we got good and wet going home. And it was just farm life. I was raised on the farm. The sharecropper, Daddy only owned one phone that I can remember. What are you doing back there?
I got a great picture of you. I'm sorry. Carry on. Of you! I'll show you later.
When did you get your first TV at your grandma's house? Probably after you left, wasn't it?
No, I was in high school. We got a blind one. Daddy used to make me watch wrestling with him. He'd get down the floor and he'd slap the floor with the referee or umpire, what they call him, and make sure he counted right. And I'd still see him. He'd wear overalls, call them undershirts, I guess.
Yeah.
One strap undone, he'd be down the floor making sure that he got that count right.
Love it.
The only one that took the liking for wrestling is our older son's wife, wrestler. He has to take her to watch wrestling every once in a while. And she watches that a lot, Lisa. But and we don't do it too much anymore, but when they come to the house, we used to play games, croquet, and the one where you throw the sock in the box, in on the hole, and
cornhole.
What you call it.
Cornhole, I think, is what they call it now.
Yeah. What did you guys call it?
She said it was hard.
Hard.
Hard, it was hard.
It was hard, yes.
And hillbilly golf.
Hillbilly golf, yeah. At your house.
Yeah, we just play hillbilly golf at our campground. We belong to a campground down below West Plains, yeah. And there'd be a lot of, most of the senior citizens down there, and we'd get together and play hillbilly golf. And, just different things, music mostly, because John plays music, and there's several of them down there that did, and we'd have dances at the clubhouse, and we'd go outside in the summertime and sit on the picnic tables and bring up chairs, and as it got colder, we'd have a fire outside, and we'd sit around the fire and then play music, and we'd all sing or listen to them. It had been a boring life, I tell you what. You can make fun out of about anything if you want to bad enough, and you can have a good life if you want to bad enough. But the first thing you got to do is find Jesus Christ, and then that's when the good times start. That's what started me, and I wasn't a Christian until I was 26 years old. Now, how old was I when you were born? 26.
I made you turn to God.
You were that old.
You're welcome.
I went to the hospital and got my fingers pricked to find out how low my blood was. Then I went to the beauty shop and had this do done, and then we drove over here.
Well, see, I think she's talking about craft-wise. Are you doing any sewing or anything else like that?
Oh, that's true, yeah.
Singing. Yeah. I tried.
I didn't know you could sing.
I didn't either. I sing when I really try.
Well, we got
his family sang, and I just never did feel comfortable trying to sing with family that grew up singing in church. And so I'm catching on late, but I'll get there. The Lord leads me here home.
Write songs. You have written a lot of songs.
Yeah.
How many have you? You know?
Oh my goodness.
I imagine over 100 or so.
Wow. Yeah, the CDs we were playing, there's, I think, about 12 songs on each of those CDs that you gave me. Mm-hmm. So there's 24 of them back there. We've been playing songs, yeah.
I was listening to him sing downstairs last night, and he was singing one of my songs.
Uh-huh.
And I wrote, "Here Comes the Night Again."
A lot of people don't know everything that you have done because you've been so humble all these years. You have pretty much dedicated your life to taking care of us and encouraging us, promoting us. So I just think it's wonderful that Grace put this together to showcase many of your talents.
Grace is, she's just special.
Oh, this is not about me. Not about me.
Grandma over there thinks so too.
Yeah.
That's right.
Next week will be a full blown turkey dinner, so y'all come back.
Turkey's in the freezer.
Okay. Glad to hear.
When did you start sewing?
At home. I was in high school.
Did you
start out making? Pardon? Would you start out making little skirts, vests?
Skirts mostly, and I made some aprons and a dress or two, and then. Well, I was home, I moved to Nashville, and I lived at the YWCA for 2 years till we married. And they had a sewing machine, a pedal sewing machine out in the hall. And I'd take my fabric pattern out there and I'd sew. And I made a poodle skirt. I don't know whatever happened to that, a pink poodle skirt, but you know, we used to wear it somewhere. I've lost a lot of stuff over the years. I mean, for 81 years, you lose a lot. us. And some of us you just throw away.
Now, I know that you worked at a, was it a wedding dress shop?
Yeah, for a little while.
Okay. All right, so what did you get into with that?
I got a discount on Julie's wedding
dress. you did a lot of sewing for them, though.
I did.
Yeah.
The lady down the street that owned a sewing shop, and she approached me one time. She knew I sewed it. She was needing help making her wedding dresses that she had. And I don't know if I'd come up and help her. At that time, it was in Cave Springs. Mm-hmm. And so I went up and worked there some more. And then when she moved over to Chesterfield, I went over there and worked quite a bit. So she gave me a discount on everything, and I practically paid for her dress with sewing. But I still got it too.
That's right.
Can't get her to take it.
Should have brought it over here.
Now, what? A lot of stuff you started on at home when you were growing up was for your guys' wear. Necessity, did you make a lot of your own clothes?
No, Mother made my clothes. Okay. Mother was a good seamstress too. That's where I got mine at. So she could look at something, you could tell her what you wanted, and she cut newspaper patterns out. She knew it. So wow. I didn't play good sis at my mom. My mom was a good seamstress. Yeah.
Taylor's pretty good. I guess it just skipped me.
Yeah. Taylor knew about anything she wanted to do.
Taylor's my cousin and Julie's daughter, so
yeah.
that's who Taylor is.
My Gracie is very talented, so is her sister Rachel and her two brothers. They're all talented. Julie's daughter just made
up and coming 20.
Upper 20 of what?
It's in St. Louis. It's for accountants and private equity people and things
and
I don't understand.
Her brother, her son, was in a St. Louis
Homes magazine.
Because he decorated a house near us. We went out and walked to see what he'd done, and he had decorated this house for Christmas for this lady. And it was full page right up there.
So basically, it's your talent has and creativity has disseminated amongst the ranks.
That's very true.
I had a little bit of effect on that when I taught her how to draw our first rose.
Mm-hmm. That's true.
Remember when we used to take quarters and make the center and take nickels and make the
rose? Yep,
on the side,
that's right. Yep.
And draw a stem and leaves, and you got it.
You got it. Perfect. I know how to count money too.
This rose is worth 75 cents.
Yes. Yeah.
But I'll tell you what, anybody who wants a home in a family, I highly recommend it, because mm-hmm. they've been a blessing to me. Got three of them. That's a preacher. The older boy, he's playing in church now, singing, he and his dad. And
Black Sheep. Well, I'm the reason you became a Christian, I guess. Mary's a preacher.
It was actually came along, but it wasn't you.
Julie's the real reason for the season.
I was on my knees so much I almost took to wearing knee pads.
Disrupting people's lives since 1968.
Young people, let me tell you now, when you go through life, you're going to have knocks and downs and ups and all kinds of problems, but you just look at the Lord and take you right through it. And it doesn't guarantee you won't have trouble, but it'll help you to handle it.
Any chance you're going to do any more drawing or painting?
Yeah, probably.
Yeah.
Mostly writing now, though.
Yeah, you haven't stopped that.
But anybody knows anybody who can hear some songs? Publisher.
Yeah.
Never had any luck there, because you just about have to know somebody to get the music business.
Yeah.
And you have to be a good singer. I can write, but singing is not my strong point.
I'll sing a song.
Lily.
There
we go.
Awesome.
One of my songs.
Oh yeah.
Okay. You gonna do it now?
You gotta pick one.
Well, yeah. I appreciate you going to all this trouble, Gracie. Yes. I know it's been working. Where's that boy from your neck? I understand you got in home too. But when you come to my house, one thing I'm going to put on is that top on. Well, I won't say too much about it.
Right.
No, you wear your hat however you want it. That's what I tell everybody. There's something you ought to do, enjoy doing, want to be. Because nobody's going to ever say, come on, if you do this, you got to jump in there and do it for yourself.
Yep. That's right.
You can get some help, but the idea's going to come from you, you got to be able to put in the work.
Yep.
Well, thank you everybody for coming. Yeah. And thank you, Grandma, for coming.